Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's discuss something called the endo effect. We have a Diels-Alder cycloaddition on the screen. The diene is kind of special. It's a cyclic diene called cyclopentadiene. The dienophile is methyl acrylate. This reaction can give two different products. I've shown one on the top and the other on the bottom. These are diastereomers of each other. I've numbered both to highlight the cyclohexene ring embedded in the products, but let's redraw them to show their three-dimensional shape as bicyclic rings. Here is the top cycloaddict. And here, very similar, is the bottom. Bottom one. They only differ by the configuration of this stereocenter. The top structure is called the endo product. The bottom one is called the exo product. In this reaction, the endo is the major product. What's the deal? Why is the endo product favored? On the screen, I've shown how the diene and dienophile approach each other for the exo on the left and endo right products. I've tried to draw these structures with perspective, like we're looking at the edge of the molecules. In the exo reaction on the left, the EWG on the dienophile sticks out towards us. This looks fine. In the endo diagram on the right, the EWG on the dienophile tucks under the diene. This looks crowded, sterically hindered. In fact, it is. By sterics, the endo product is disfavored. However, putting the pi system of the EWG, the carbonyl pi bond, near the pi system of the diene gives unexpected stabilization. This stabilization is called secondary orbital overlap. Honestly, I don't understand it, but it's apparently real. More than offsets any steric hindrance and causes the endo product to be the major observed product. Let's draw the endo product flat. Here's our cyclohexene. We'll number our carbons. Let's draw everything with a bolded bond as up. So that's these two H's, those are 5 and 6. This CH2 off of 1 and 4 will be up, and everything else must be down in a sense. So these hydrogens are down, down, down. Yes, I admit that these two stereocenters are particularly horrific as represented. Flat pictures do not work for all molecules. Let's also draw the prettier version of this endo product. Great. We call this product the endo product, because the main group on the dienophile, the ester, has an endo orientation. It was tucked under the dienophile during the reaction. Any group that was tucked under is also endo. So the ester was endo. This hydrogen as well, it is an endo hydrogen. This hydrogen is considered to be exo. And so it's hard to draw, but that hydrogen as well. In other words, even the endo product has groups in exo positions. Regardless, we call this structure the endo product because the most important group on the dienophile, the ester, is oriented endo. That's the endo effect. We'll practice predicting the endo product in the next video.